Ready?
Go! We're here to bring you the first C-plus rap. These rhymes are fire, no cap.
You've seen interviews, hype vids, Naruto. That's proof that this is the best show.
Calhoun Plus comes out Thursday. Once you watch one, you'll be here to stay.
Every new week, we got something different. You already know our uploads are consistent.
Freestyle!
Oh well, I'm drawing a blank. But don't forget to watch Turn to Shark Tank.
Along with cynicisms and kicking it with Kenny. Watch all that without paying a penny.
I'm going to sleep.
Construction all about?
Construction's all about more based on residential type construction, home building, electrical, safety, just all aspects put in together. It can range from framing, which we're doing here, we're making some playhouses, but that's more involved with roofing as well, and siding. Sort of touches a little bit on everything.
Yeah. And what are y'all doing right now?
Right now we are, I have two carpentry classes, one class is working on this project, one that you filming earlier. They're making 8 by 12 playhouses that we will build up, construct just like you would construct the house, and then late spring should be able to sell our auction off to somebody.
Thank you. So how many years have you been in construction?
Been in construction for 4 years now.
Okay, and how are you liking it?
Pretty good.
So how many years have you been in construction?
4.
What do you like about construction?
I like building stuff. Hanging out.
It's cool.
Would you rather have more time or more money, and why?
More time, because you can make more money with more time.
Would you rather explore space or the ocean, and why?
The ocean, because space is scary.
Would you rather have a rewind button or a pause button? And why?
Rewind so I can go fix a screw up.
Would you rather be a kid your entire life or an adult your entire life?
A kid, because you don't have to do anything.
Would you rather send a phone call or send a text, and why?
Text. I like talk to people.
Audio message.
Would you rather spend one night in a luxury hotel or out camping in the middle of woods?
Hotel.
Definitely hotel. I'm just not a, like, outdoors type person. I feel like a bear's just gonna pop up in my tent and just start feasting, and that's not the move, so.
Would you rather meet George Washington or the current president, and why?
George Washington, because he seems like a cool guy.
Would you rather end all wars or stop world hunger, and why?
I would rather stop world hunger because no one deserves to be hungry.
Would you rather work in a group or work alone, and why?
Group, because I'm talkative.
Would you rather receive cash or gifts on your birthday?
Cash.
Why?
Well, I would rather have cash because I get to buy whatever I want with it. Yeah.
Would you rather speak everything on your mind or never speak again?
Speak everything on my mind. People need to be more honest these days, you know? They need to know what other people are thinking.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. My music hits me so hard, makes me say, oh my Lord, thank you for blessing me. What am I to rhyme and to hype? It feels good when you know you're down. A super dope homeboy from the Oak Town, and I'm known as such. And this is a beat you can't touch. I told you, homeboy, you can't touch this. Yeah, that's how we living, and you know you can't touch this. Look in my eyes, man, you can't touch this. Yo, let me bust the funky lyrics. Fresh new kicks and bands. You got it like that. Now you know you want to dance. So move out of your seat and get a fire girl and catch this beat while it's rolling. Hold on. Pump a little bit and let the noise go on. Like that. Like that. Pull a little bit, just fall on back. Let them know that you're too much. And this is a beat they can't touch. Yo, I told you. You can't touch this. Why you standing there, man? Can't touch this. Yo, sound the bell. School is in, sucker. You can't touch this. Give me a song, a rhythm, making them sweat. That's what I'm giving them now. They know. You talk about the hammer, you're talking about a show that's hyped and tight. Singles are sweating so fast, them a white or a tape. To learn what's it gonna take in the 90s to burn the charts. Legit. Either work hard or you might as well quit. That's word, because you know you can't touch this. Can't touch this. Break it down.
Hello, I'm Parker Lesher. I'm here with Adam Brown, and we're talking about what's new in Calhoun, and we're here at Dollar Days. Tell us about Dollar Days.
So Dollar Days is a store that we buy liquidated goods from online retailers and offer them at a really reduced price. Anything from electronics to household items. It's kind of a little bit of a scavenger hunt. You never know what you're going to find.
So you mentioned scavenger hunt, and scavenger hunts are always fun. But what inspired you to make Dollar Days?
So I spent probably 12-plus years in corporate management, transportation, particularly, and I was just really tired of it. Burnout, heart wasn't in it. Wanted to do something for my own. And I've always wanted, of course, my heart is always to protect and provide for my family. And that's something we wanted to always keep in mind. So this came about to start this, and we did. And it's also helped us broaden our family. We were able to take on some foster children and help help that market as well, or that area of need. We're the back of our store. We have clothing closets for children that may come into care and don't have anything. You know, they can come in here and get whatever they need, clothes and personal hygiene items to be able to take with them. Store itself offers some really good savings to anybody, the regular consumer as well as resellers that want to come in and purchase things and resell in the marketplace to help bridge a gap in their household income. We've have some that even advertise they've made up to $60,000 a year just off of reselling this product out of these stores. So that's a huge income. But then we have the everyday consumer that just wants to buy things for their household and save money. The single mothers that come in and buy cases of diapers and are able to save money and provide for their children.
So you mentioned savings, and we came in the other day and we actually found some pretty cool stuff. And then today we actually found some other cool things, as in like AirPods. You know, these are, I don't even know how much, but you can come get them here for not as much as in a Walmart or something.
$5.
Yep, and then you got a Google Wi-Fi system. And then we actually have something my mom and dad probably would love, because they drink so much coffee. is like a Bubba insulated cup, which is another like, you know, $15 at another store. So tell us about your savings and how like you can save money here.
So we have a wide variety of product, anything from your health and beauty aid type stuff to general household stuff to electronics. We've had iPads, MacBooks, regular laptops, iPhones, Samsung phones. You never know what you're going to find, but nothing is ever more than $5 on Saturday or Sunday, no matter the retail value. Monday, whatever's left is $3, and Tuesday, whatever's left is $1.
Wow, that's a great saving. You know, finding AirPods for $5, you don't really see that every day. But would you like to tell anything else about Dollar Days?
Yeah, I'd love for everybody to come see us. There's still a lot of people that have never made their first visit. I'd love for teachers, students, whoever, to come down and visit with us and find some good deals. The address is 637 Uthkaluga Street, Calhoun, Georgia, 30701.
Thank you, and thank you again for letting us come in and interview you. Adam has asked y'all to send him a friend request on Facebook because every Thursday and Saturday he sends out a highlight video of what is going to be in the store, so you can get a sneak peek of what you could possibly find in the store. And the hours behind me here for Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday.
Hello, this is Physics with Parth. Today we got my instructor, Coach Robertson. You gotta say hi.
Hello.
And this is Physics with Parth and a couple other people. So, we are going to explain to you what we are going to do in this video. First and foremost, we will explain clearly the difference between kinetic and potential
energy.
Then, we will identify the types of potential energy in a system and give examples for various
types.
Then, identify the areas in a system where potential and kinetic energy
exist.
Right. And last, apply the formulas for kinetic and potential energy to determine the amount of energy in a
system.
All right. What's up? I'm Marvin. I'm with Physics with Parth. See Parth down there? He chilling. And today, I'm going to tell you the difference between potential energy and kinetic energy. Potential energy is the stored energy in an object or system because of its position or configuration. Right? All right, cool. So kinetic energy is the energy of a body or system with respect to the motion of the body or of the particles in the system. So let me show you guys an example. So anything that's on basically like a surface and it has the potential to fall, it can have potential energy. So you see that body armor over there? It can fall whenever, like just basically whenever.
Jello beats, holla at me.
Like that. It can fall. It's still falling. Another example of potential energy would be my man's Parth right here. He's dangling a little bit. Let me see how you feel, Parth.
Not safe right now. Help.
All right, now time to show you some kinetic energy.
Here we have an example of Coach using a rubber band, an example on Marvin for potential and kinetic energy. He pulls it back for potential energy. And you see here he releases it. And that's the kinetic energy as the band is hitting Marvin. Welcome to Physics with Parth. We are doing this interview with Professor Jesus Torrado and Professor Alex Rodriguez. Welcome to the interview. Thank you for being here. So we're just going to ask you a few questions.
What is potential energy?
Say it right. Say this like a bow and arrow. I'm doing this right. It's storing the energy. Yeah.
What's kinetic energy?
It's like the process of the body being in motion, you know? So like if I'm moving, you know, as I am, that's kinetic energy right there. Right? Yeah.
What's an example of potential energy in a system?
Say I'm up here, right? I have the potential to fall.
So see, right. So he's gonna be up here, bro, and he's a snowboarder. So when he starts moving down, that's when he starts getting kinetic energy because he's in motion and he's going down. You feel me?
Yeah, I feel you.
Okay, let's do some equations.
If a 0.500 kilogram mass is hung from a clock that is raised 1 meter, then its GPE is. In order to find the answer to this question, you have to plug it into the potential energy formula, which is mass times gravity times height. So the mass would be 0.500 kilograms times gravity, which is 9.8, and then times your height, which is 1 meter. And when you plug this into your calculator, you get 4.90 joules, because energy is always in joules. In order to calculate the kinetic energy of a 200 kilogram object that is moving with a speed of 15 meters per second, you have to plug in your values into the kinetic energy formula. So for this problem, it would be 1/2 times the mass, which is 200 kilograms, times the velocity, which is 15 meters per second, squared. And when you plug that into your calculator, you get 45,000. And the units for kinetic energy is always joules. And that's your answer.
What got you motivated into teaching?
Oh, motivation. Well, I always enjoyed school. I grew up, my mother was a teacher and eventually administrator. I was actually pre-med at the time, and I remember being home at Christmas break, and it was my sophomore year, and I just decided, you know, I really want to kind of move into education. I really like coaching and being around sports. So I guess my motivating factor was how I grew up and then just making a determination of how I want to spend my life coaching and teaching youth.
What school did you go to?
I went to the University of Georgia. Loved it. Go Dogs.
What got you interested in the biology?
I've always loved biology. It's, of course, a life science, and it's continually growing. New species are found every year. To me, it's one of the best hands-on sciences there are, so I just enjoy having fun with it.
What is your favorite experiment?
Dissections are really cool. Anytime you get to see the inside of something and, you know, see kids amazed, sickened, and happy and grossed out all at the same time is pretty fun.
Welcome back, you guys. It's your boy Felipe Barrios, man. You know, it's been for a while that. What are you doing? Hey, what are you doing?
Limpiando.
What are you doing?
Limpiando.
What are you doing here?
Limpiando.
I'm doing work.
Limpiando.
I thought you were doing work. Welcome back, you guys. It's your boy, Felipe Barrios, bringing you guys the premiere of the Reoski News Season 2.
Oh. He needs some milk.
Ahora sí, los dueños del swing, pa' que sepa.
Barrios over here bringing you guys with another news coverage. Sadly, this is gonna be our last season because, you know, I'm a senior. Everyone around this room is a senior. Even though there's no one around this room recording, Freddy is quarantined. RIP to Freddy. He's not dead. I just don't want to see him. Anyways, guys, it's been 2 years that we haven't recorded something here in the Reoski News. Imagine 2019. 2019. What's 2 plus 0 plus 1 plus 9? 12.
It's 12.
Anyways, in the first covers that we have our boy, Orozco. Alex, my man, Orozco. Let's take it to him. Alex!
Hey. I won the tape.
How you doing?
He's very Oscar-ness.
Oh, y'all filming this?
Now we're gonna go to our new weatherman, because apparently our other weatherman is pretty trash, man. But this man is the man of the weather of the man. Let's go to our boy, Parth, the one and only Patel. Oh, Parth! Parth, you're on!
Okay, so for the weather today, we got a bunch of water. For the week, get your barrels out. It tells you know what I mean. Yeah, that's pretty much it. And some snow, if you can see. There you go.
Until next time, guys, on the Rioscar.
I think that's him. That looks like him, I think. Yeah, it looks like him.
My name's Quincy. I'm a D1 unit. Power forward, number 15.
Hi, I'm Jackson Bridges. I'm here interviewing Mr.
Quincy Smith.
Is your name Jeffrey?
No.
Okay. Here's my list of questions. Here's my microphone. Let's just jump into it, you know? Is it true that you're a D1 Duke commit? I heard you talking about it on the way out.
Yes, I am committed to Duke as a power forward.
What's that?
Position in basketball.
Good for you. So, does this mean you have a scholarship to Duke?
Yeah.
Impressive. This one's a bit controversial, but I heard that you didn't make the high school basketball. So I heard you've been bragging about you're on a rec team with 13-year-olds? We'll return shortly. I've heard from a certain Philip Pham that you are 6'5 and cannot dunk.
He's dead.
He's dead? I'll let him know. So I talked to you privately about how you had a private trainer. How's that going along?
It's pretty good. His name is Michael Jordan. You might have heard of him. He's like 6 rings or something, 6 MVPs, something like that. It's really good.
Has he taught you a lot?
No. I taught him everything he knows.
Is that true?
Yeah. I got him in 6 rings.
That's impressive.
Yeah.
How would you describe your basketball skills?
Phenomenal. Can't be stopped. Monster on the court.
Monster on the court, folks. And can we see some of that?
Maybe. I don't know.
Yep.
Back to
put your mask on. We are going on a drive around vlog adventure. Okay, so on our adventure to-do list today is get gas, get food, and figure out life.
We're gonna do it.
Welcome to my two-door 1998 Ford Ranger.
This is a nice car. There's a little car tour. That's it.
That's the whole car.
Look, we got a cool little time lapse set up right there.
Yeah,
that we will insert. We will insert it right here. Ding.
Yeah.
the gas place at Kroger.
Kroger.
Here's a clip of Mary Grace getting gas. She spotted us. Go away.
This is Mary Grace getting gas.
I didn't select the fuel grid. Oops.
Okay, now do you think I can prop fueling. This up on the... This is safe.
Out for that car,
so
I'm gonna look out for you.
It's fine, we won't get run over.
Sure.
We made it inside the store. Let's go to the craft section.
They've got Easter.
Oh, Easter, okay.
Is Mary this? Grace has found something. No pants, no problem.
Walmart Calhoun, everybody.
We left the Easter section and now we're going to the craft section. And yes, there's people watching me vlog right now, but do I care?
Well, let's just get clipped out on the floor.
I've got no dignity left.
Little montage clip.
We got Mario and Luigi.
Look, I'm pretty sure this is not real.
Wait, how is the- what is the dog doing? What is that?
What is that?
Freddy's.
But Freddy that doesn't Walker. Exist. That character does not exist. That's teaching kids to do graffiti and vandalism.
Look.
I feel like you shouldn't touch that.
Oh, it's
that.
Subway Surfers.
Oh, dude, I love Subway Surfers. It's good to be home.
Friends
welcome.
And family. Dogs welcome. People tolerate.
Aw, that's so cute.
Dude, I found something.
I think I'm gonna get it.
That's the cringiest thing I've ever seen.
This gotta be
I
green.
Like that one better. Some JoJo Siwa shoes over here.
A lot of the clips we get at Walmart are gonna be unusable because there's children yelling in the background.
Okay, we're leaving. We'll get back to you in the car. Bye.
Don't touch my Ford Ranger.
Because you didn't lock my door.
I didn't know I had to.
Bucky does not have automatic locks, okay? I'm sorry.
My bad.
He's from 1998. Maybe 97. I don't rightly remember.
Clank. Okay, made it to Chick-fil-A. We came to Chick-fil-A without Trip, so...
Why do my hair stick up like this?
I
hate the wintertime.
Because you have to lock your door. Or it's illegal.
We almost died.
Oh, it's fine. I'm just going to go.
Okay. That's enough for them.
It's hot.
Hot.
Uh-huh.
Whoa, dude.
Okay, I'm going to be honest. I don't know who to yield to here.
You're not yielding. You're at a red light.
Left turn yield on flashing arrow.
That means you don't turn unless you can when the light's yellow. I'm driving next time.
Okay. And that's then the Minecraft drinking sound.
No, it's not.
Okay, sorry. Okay, turn!
This is your sauce.
Okay, who do I have to yield to here?
You go.
But it says
no, just
yield.
Go. Okay.
Your job is to look out for police cars, okay?
Police!
Don't okay. do that.
Whoever gets to the stop, pedestrians always have the right of way.
I know. Not if I don't stop, they don't. How many questions do you have?
No. Oh. Did you want a red light?
But it stopped going.
Trip. We're back at school.
My fry wasn't cooked all the way.
I'm so sorry.
Chick-fil-A. There's someone coming!
You're never invited back into my car again. Let me prop it up all your sunglasses. Engineering student.
Fries.
Do you throw away your extra packets?
Depends on what it is.
Don't ever do that.
You keep them all. Thank you for joining us. This was fun. And that's it. Peace.
Ouch. Enough of that.